A Philippine lawmaker warns his colleagues against passing an unfunded third COVID-19 stimulus package. House Deputy Speaker Isidro Ungab says the bayanihan to arise as one bill needs to have a well-defined source of funding. Under the proposal, the 405 billion peso stimulus package will be funded primarily using the unprogrammed fund of the 2021 budget. But Ungab points out the Departments of Finance and Budget, as well as the Bureau of Treasury, failed to give a concrete commitment to fund the measure. He says without it, there will be no source of revenue for the bill, which aims to provide assistance to Filipinos bearing the brunt of the pandemic. The House of Representatives began its plenary deliberations on the Bayanihan 3 bill on Monday, with 293 lawmakers signed as authors of its consolidated version.
Moody's Analytics tags the Philippines as the clear laggard in Asia. It says any return by the country to pre-pandemic output levels won't be achieved until the end of next year. That's in contrast to the recovery already attained by the economies of China, Taiwan, South Korea, and Vietnam. Indonesia and Thailand are also on track to return to pre-pandemic levels this year. Moody's Analytics sees a 5.3% growth for the Philippine economy this year. The government forecast is 6-7%. Moody's notes the country's struggle in containing new COVID-19 infections amid decentralized health policies and a sluggish vaccination program. A House panel has approved the bills granting congressional franchises to two of the country's biggest water concessionaires, Maynilad and Manila Water. The bills seek to extend the authority of Maynilad and Manila Water to establish, operate, and maintain waterworks and sewerage in Metro Manila and nearby provinces for 25 more years. It only took the House Committee on Legislative Franchises one day to deliberate on both bills, a stark contrast to the 13 hearings the panel conducted before it jumped the renewal of the ABS-CBN franchise last year. House Deputy Minority Leader Carlos Zarate strongly objected to the swift grant of the franchises at the committee level. Zarate says the panel disregarded the issues raised by Metro Manila's water regulator. He also noted the absence of the government officials who negotiated for the new concession deals with the two water providers after the Justice Department found onerous provisions in the original agreements. Deputy Speaker Lito Atienza also believes the committee railroaded the two franchises. He urges his colleagues to be more thorough during the plenary debates.